Hi there, this video is a follow-on to an earlier video on writing a macro to create hyperlinks to worksheets in Excel. As we can see, we have our list of worksheets containing financials for different business units. However, what if we want to create a table of contents based on selected worksheets only? Go to Visual Basic for Applications and insert a module. It is best to insert the option Explicit Syntax at the start of your module because it will force us to implicitly declare variables for each individual macro we write. We will call the macro List Selected Sheet Names. Next, we want to disable these Excel properties in order to improve the performance of the macro. Now we need to declare our object variables for the selected sheets hyperlinks macro. We are going to add an error handler to the macro, which will prevent the macro running if only our index sheet is selected. Otherwise, the macro will proceed to clear all cells in columns A to B in Index Sheet, Sheet 1, or Start WKS. This line of highlighted code is critical in order to reference solely the selected worksheets in the active workbook. Whilst this piece of code will prevent the macro referencing the index page, Sheet 1. We can now write the code to reference the selected worksheets. This highlighted portion of the code is the most critical because we are dynamically referencing each separate worksheet in our selected sheets. Please take your time when writing this part of the code, as a basic misspelling will void the macro's complete and successful creation of the hyperlinked table of contents. The next WKS syntax will move the macro to the next worksheet in the selection. Given the macro's loop through all the worksheets, we are ready to move the cursor back to the index sheet. Let's label cell A1 in the index sheet, table of contents, with a bold font. Once the macro is complete, it is best practice to clear the two object variables so the macro can run again from scratch without remembering these variables going forward. We can now re-enable the Excel properties which were earlier disabled because our macro is complete. We have finished writing the macro. Let's review our macro one final time. As a matter of fact, I forgot to set the values for our two object variables. First, we need to state the start WKS or our start worksheet. Then our start range or start cell in our index sheet. Let's run our macro. We will choose the sheets Alpha, Juliet, Uniform and Whiskey. As we can see, our macro is working and is correctly hyperlinking to the respective worksheets.